Hello students, welcome back. Today we shall continue our exercise questions on page number 21 of your textbook. In the last class we discussed about the first question. Let's move to the second question. The terms in two positions of some arithmetic sequences are given below. Write the first five terms of each. Here, given that third term is 34 and sixth term is 67, we have to calculate first five terms of the sequence. Third term equal to 34 and sixth term equal to 67. We have to find the first five terms of the sequence. Using the given terms, first we have to find the common difference. Common difference is equal to term difference by position difference. That means x6 minus x3 divided by 6 minus 3. And it is equal to 67 minus 34 divided by 6 minus 3. It is equal to 33 by 3 and it is equal to 11. So D equal to 11. Hence we can write the arithmetic sequence as, here the first and second terms are not given, third term is given as 34, and fourth term and fifth term are not given, and sixth term is given as 67. Using the third term and common difference, first we have to find the second term. It is equal to 34 minus 11, 23. Next, using the second term and common difference, we have to find the first term, and it is equal to 12. Next, using the third term and common difference, we have to find the fourth term, and it is equal to 34 plus 11, 45. Next, using the fourth term and common difference, we got fifth term as 56. Next, given that second term is 5 and fifth term is 2, using this term, first we have to find the common difference. Common difference is equal to x5 minus x2 divided by 5 minus 2, and it is equal to 2 minus 5 divided by 5 minus 2. 2 minus 5 equal to minus 3 divided by 3, and it is equal to minus 1. So we got common difference as minus 1. Next we have to calculate the terms of the arithmetic sequence. Second term is equal to 5 and common difference is minus 1. So we got first term as 5 minus of minus 1 and it is equal to 6. Then using the second term and common difference, we have to find the third term. 5 plus minus 1 and it is equal to 4. Using the third term and common difference, we have to find the fifth term. So 4 plus minus 1 and it is equal to 3. So we got the complete sequence. Next, question number 3. The fifth term of an arithmetic sequence is 38 and the ninth term is 66. What is its 25th term? Here, given that fifth term is 38 and ninth term is 66. We have to find the 25th term of this arithmetic sequence. Using the given terms, first we have to find the common difference. Common difference is equal to 66 minus 38 divided by 9 minus 5. That means term difference by position difference. And it is equal to 28 by 4 and it is equal to 7. So we got D as 7. There are two methods to find the 25th term. First method, we get 25th term from the 5th term. We must add the common difference 20 times. Once again, we get the 25th term from the 5th term. We must add the common difference 20 times. 25th term is equal to 5th term plus 20d. When 5th term is given as 38 plus 20 into 7, it is equal to 38 plus 140 and it is equal to 178. Next, second method, we get 25th term from 9th term. We must add the common difference 16 times. Once again, we get 25th term from 9th term, we must add common difference 16 times. That means 25th term is equal to 9th term plus 16d. D is equal to 66 plus 16 into 7. It is equal to 66 plus 112 and it is equal to 178. So we got 25th term as 178. Next, question number 4. Is 101 a term of the arithmetic sequence 13, 24, 35, etc. What about 1001? Here, a sequence is given as 13, 24, 35, etc. We have to check whether 101 and 1001 is a term or not. Using the given sequence, first we have to find the common difference. Common difference is equal to second term minus first term and it is equal to 11. First we have to check 101 is a term or not. First we have to subtract the first term 13 from 101. That means 101 minus 13 and it is equal to 88. Next we have to check whether 88 is a multiple of the common difference 11. It is very clear that 88 is a multiple of 11 because 8 into 11 equal to 88. From this we can say that 101 is a term of the given arithmetic sequence. In the similar way, we have to check whether 1001 is a term or not. First, we have to subtract the first term 13 from 1001. That means 1001 minus 13. It is equal to 988. Next, we have to check 988 is a multiple of the common difference 11 or not. It is very clear that 988 is not a multiple of 11. So, it is not a term of the given arithmetic sequence. Is it clear for you, children? Okay. Children, listen carefully. Next, I will explain about some important points. Point number 1. If x1, x2, x3, etc., xn are n terms of an arithmetic sequence, the number of terms between x1 and xn equal to last term minus first term divided by common difference plus 1. Point number 2. For a set of natural numbers, the number of terms is equal to last term minus first term plus 1. Is it clear for you, children? Okay.